Okay, first of all, create a folder testn for a new virtual environment. Then type in env to create a new environment in that folder. Exit and pretend that we start off with the newly created environment. Hit list and you see only a few packages there. Here I just upgrade pip and install the NiceGUI package. Now NiceGUI version 1.2.6 is there. We need the request HTML package for our app, so just pip install the package. Okay, deactivate it and restart the environment. We'll be using the Python idle to code. Control N to start a new file. Here I just name it test app 1. Import UI from NiceGUI and the HTML session from request HTML. Usually, I'll name the three sections of our app, the click event, elements, and the run app part. Create a text area to allow inputting URL and a text area for inputting the CSS selector. We also need a click button to scrape text. Now, under click events, define the scrape text function. I'm not going to explain the details here. If you want to dig deep, feel free to click the link in the description. Since we have a variable result, we need to define the result below. It's just a text area to display whatever text you scrape from the targeted website. Finally, we add an exception class to deal with whatever situations that we don't expect to happen. F5 to run it. And you should see a simple interface has been created. As you can see, it's not responsive, but we'll leave it for now. Let's see if it can scrape text from website. Paste web URL here. Enter the CSS selector. Hit the scrape text button. And here is the result. Let's check if it corresponds to the website. Looks good. Let's add some CSS style to the result text area. Simply add a style attribute after the result element. F5 to run it again. Seems like the browser catched our previous result. Then we simply change our output to a window mode display. F5, run it again. And you should see a new layout. Let's take a look at the original layout. This is the original layout. It's not responsive. Let's change it back to the CSS style. There we go. Just check if it can scrape the web. Good. Then I exit everything. Install auto-py-to-exe to package the Python file to a Windows executable. This is what I did in auto-py-to-exe. Under script location, point to our app's Python file. Select one directory. Window mode and add the folders of the following packages from our virtual environment. NiceGUI, Fast API, UVCon, Stylet, WebView, Request, and Request HTML. Then for the output directory, I just point to the app folder in my USB. And convert .py to .exe. Once it's done, open output folder to navigate to our apps folder. Scroll down to the execute file. Click it and I got the error message. I'm not sure what I did wrong. If you know how to fix it, please let me know. Thank you. Ciao.